One of the most influential podcasters today is Joe Rogan. The reason why Joe is so successful as a podcaster is that early on he decided he was going to create a very unique platform for his podcasting, and that platform consisted of video. And by producing video during his podcast, it gave him the ability to dominate between YouTube and other podcast platforms. This is a unique format, and I believe that more people should take a look at this format going forward. And that's exactly what we're going to do today in this podcast. When it comes to building your brand and creating momentum, one of the best things you can do is create content that can be absorbed through multiple platforms, meaning Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, especially YouTube. With podcasting today, if you're recording video, you have the opportunity of breaking that content down into two separate formats, yet similar. You could use snippets from your video podcast to market your standard audio podcast and vice versa. And here we are in 2020. The game should be for most of us to include a video element into our podcasting. And if you are more video-centric, perhaps you want to include some podcasting into your video. If, like many of us, when we're driving to work or we're out throughout our day and you're listening to public radio, if you've noticed over a great period of time, many of the radio stations now include a membership where you can see the live video or recorded from those sessions. So when they're in studio and they're going through all their shenanigans, there's video being recorded. And that's just another level of content that they're providing to their listeners. So moving forward during your podcast, if you're going to be doing interviews, you can consider that a long form format for your podcast. And if you're also recording video with that, the advantage I think is going to be tremendous is that when you break that down and you segment it into episodes or sub-episodes, that's going to give more people an opportunity to consume your content. On a day, say someone's in the gym and they're working out, even though you may be producing primarily to YouTube, most people are not going to be watching YouTube videos while they're working out. At the same time, you can approach that same client base or that same demographic with a podcast, because now they have their headphones in and they're working out and they're listening to your podcast. Most of the time, what they're hearing is exactly what they would hear in your videos. So a great way to cross promote those two platforms is that at some point in your video, you mention your podcast, and at some point in your podcast, you do the same by mentioning your YouTube channel. That combination, I think, will be powerful for acquiring consistent listeners. And that's the key in podcasting or YouTube. If you're monetizing on YouTube, you already know that one of the most important things is that you can get someone to watch that video, not just watch it for a few seconds, but YouTube ranks it by how long they actually engage with the video. Many podcasting platforms are doing basically the same thing because they're also ad-based. So the key is being able to take one long session and break it down into smaller components so that you have a chance of reaching a larger demographic of people who will listen to your podcast, who will consume your videos. I think this is going to be a powerful tool. Marketing overall for most small businesses, and they don't have a strategy to continually produce content for their customers. And that's a huge mistake. The reason why, when you think about what's going on in the world today, most businesses are going to fail. Due to the fact that they've been closed for so long, it's going to be very difficult for them to come back. This would be the perfect opportunity for someone in that business structure to be producing content and getting it out to their consumers and reassuring them that they will be coming back. Interact with them. Talk with them in the forums. Let them know the progress of what you're doing and how soon you look to be, you know, getting back to business. if you're going to be offering any specials to try and encourage them to come in, this is the perfect opportunity to get that content out to them. And I understand that a lot of small businesses don't have major budgets. They don't have a ton of money. They can just drop like the big brand stores and things like that. So podcasting and YouTube is kind of the equalizer. All you need is to take a little bit of time, write a very simple script, and follow it. You can record this on your phone. You can record the video also on your phone. And then in very simple apps, you can break it down where here's my audio file and here's my audio and video file. So this is going to go to YouTube. The audio is going to go to my podcast hosting site. And you're going to try and encourage individuals to consume that content. And a smart way to approach that is that if your business already has a Facebook presence, is to start marketing to them. Say, hey, we've created a new podcast. We've created a new YouTube channel, and we'd love to get feedback from you guys and tell us, you know, what you'd like to see, what you'd like to know about our company. Growth potential going forward is going to be based on that. It's not a maybe anymore. Today, you're going to have to really consider these hard choices, and they don't have to be hard. You can actually do a lot of this from your living room, from your bedroom, with a very simple microphone, a smartphone, and an idea. So I think that today we're going to have to rethink our marketing strategies if we're going to be successful. Yes, as a professional, of course, I want my clients to contact me and say, hey, I really need you to come in and shoot a video for us, and I really need you to come in and set up so we can do a podcast, and hey, can you help us produce the script, you know, so that there is a, you know, simple dialogue going back and forth. Yes, we're more than capable of doing those things. But in the beginning, when your budget is very, very limited, you may want to start doing this on your own. And then in the future, you can move that up to a much bigger professional production. So hopefully these tips have been helpful for you guys, and you guys will be able to create something amazing. And more importantly, keep your business afloat, because in these trying times, it's going to take a lot of work to get back to where you were just a year ago. But it doesn't have to be impossible. It's just a matter of thinking outside of the box. And I know you guys can do that, because you started, most of you started a business from scratch. I mean, literally with no funding, and look at what you built it into. Well, I don't think many people could have predicted how, you know, something like this virus would have an effect on our businesses, but here it is. So we have to contend with it. Moving forward, I would say, think about what you want your clients to know. What would you, if you were sitting next to one of these people and you would want to say something to them, or you would want to inform them of something, use that strategy when it comes to creating your videos, creating your podcasts. And I believe that that will ensure going forward that you will be successful. And even after all of this has passed, don't stop there. Keep engaging, keep interacting, keep providing and creating content, because many times people will start to look to you for that content. They want to hear more about you. You'd be amazed at how many people are interested in what the average business does or influencer. Take the time to create something amazing and put it out there into the world. You'll be amazed again how soon and how easily people will respond to it. All right, guys, this has been Rome Wilkerson. I will catch you guys in the next video/podcast. Have an amazing day.